Now, the wheels for the 2021-22 season of the Hero ISL are officially in motion, and with the fixtures now out, joining me are Rainier Fernandez from defending champions Mumbai City FC and Chinglansana Singh from Hyderabad FC, a team that really enchanted everyone with their playing style last season. Guys, have you had a chance to look at the fixtures yet?
I did. When it came out only, I got a message, and seeing that and seeing the team that we're going to face at the start only was something very surprising.
Right.
Because, last season, how it went down, during the semis and everything. So, getting back with the first game with FC Goa gives a thrill, because you ended up, the last season, the winning note with such a great, great experience of the match. And now again, we're going there again, going to play our first match, and just we all are very thrilled about it. Very excited. Yeah.
And I'm sure the mood in the Hyderabad camp is also upbeat because you guys are together for pre-season training. So what's the chatter been like so far?
We saw the picture, and it's interestingly, we are facing Chennai, I think, in the first game. Okay. And it's interesting because I think when I was with FC Goa as well, the first game was against Chennai, and it happened to be this year again. So interesting, they have a good side, and we also have started our training, and we were in the bus and we were discussing with our teammates like how it's going to be the first game and the second game we play against Rainier Mumbai City FC. We were looking at the fixture and we were very thrilled and interesting and good matches to start with. And we're excited. We are training well now and looking ahead.
Yeah, we'll come to that fixture a bit later. But Rainier, I just want to rewind a bit to last season. Now, last season, Mumbai City FC were absolutely peerless. But a new season now, a clean slate, and everyone really wants to beat the champions. So what mentality are you going into the season with this time around?
Yeah, it was a good last season. And we all were very happy with the results we got last season. But this season, it's completely new for us and for everyone. It's a new beginning for all the teams that are participating in the ISL. But we, now since we are the defending champions, we have only one goal, is to just play, improve the last season, keep improving, keep working hard and try to deliver the same or even much power, what you can say, in the following season. And we as players, we just cannot wait to get back on the field and just keep that mentality high, just believe in ourselves, work hard, be as a family, and just try to work hard in training and do everything what we have on the field and just enjoy every moment, because this experience, we all got to keep it for the rest of our lives. So this is what we are looking forward to, a great experience.
And Sana, now if I could come to you, now that you've been together with the boys in preseason for a few days now, how do you see different pieces of the jigsaw coming together? Do you feel that you've got the same vibe and energy back from last season and you can continue the good work you started into this season?
Yes, definitely. I think that's one of the key things that the club has also done, is that keeping 70% or 80% of the squad together. And we have brought in players looking at the profile and the game style that we have at Hyderabad FC. The profile that we have got in the team are definitely going to help the team, the foreign players as well as the Indian players that have come in. They're here to help us and they're looking sharp already. And as we believe in, is to focus on our style, on our duty that we have, the responsibility that we have in the team to play to our style of football, which we enjoy as the players and also the spectators who watch enjoy. And that is something which excites us, in the season. Looking forward, looking ahead with the idea, the style of play that we play. And it's all positive. And we are a team that really focus on ourselves and our style of play, and that's how we enjoy our brand of football and try to get results.
Right, so let's dig right into it now. Rainier, I'm sure you've of course had the chance to look at the fixtures like you earlier mentioned, but you're not together with the team right now. So what's the talk been on the WhatsApp groups like so far? What's the excitement
like so far? It's going great. We have a group, even my friends, Rahulin, Amay and everyone, we have a group. And when we got the fixtures, the first thing is we shared on the group, and the thrill to looking at the fixtures, the starting matches only, facing FC Goa, Hyderabad, and then ATK and the following game, and all these three games, four games, the starting only is like a banger, for us. So that shows that, we are going to come into the ISL stronger than we could ever be, because at the start only, we are going to play three top quality teams in the first three games. So with that mentality, we were really, really very excited, and we were just saying one thing, that some of our team have already started. We need to get back, we need to get stronger, and we need to do our best, And we are just very, very thrilled just to look at the fixtures, and we are very excited. So all of us are just waiting to get back on the field.
Right, right. And a bit about that encounter with Hyderabad FC now. You played them twice last season. You won one of the matches and you drew the other game. Now, on the pitch as a player, from a player's point of view, were you able to observe the unique style that Hyderabad FC played, that everyone talks about them having a unique style? Were you able to see that as a player?
Yes, yeah, of course. Like, you know, it when the first game, I think we played in Tilak Maidan, I feel. Yeah, so the first game only, like, I was not playing the first 11, but then due to some injuries, I got in the team. And so when I was playing that game, you could, like, we were obviously focusing on our style, our gameplay and all. But the moments they were, like, you know, doing the runs they were making, the ball position they were keeping, it was some quality, you know, what they had. And we could see it. But we just had to, you know, if we would have just been like, you know, lethargy, you know, keep the momentum low, it would be very difficult to play against a team like Hyderabad. But the quality of what they possessed, we had to, you know, try to top that off. And that's what we had done. And it was a good quality game from both the sides in my players' view. And yeah, they have some good quality players. Like you saw last season, you have Sana, you have Yasir, Mishra, then they were listed coming in. And the quality with the foreigners, it was really excellent. But while playing, I know we got to keep that in mind, but we got to focus on ourselves also. But yeah, it was a two good quality matches what I played against them.
Yeah. And Sana, what are your memories of playing Mumbai City FC last season and in particular facing Rainier on the pitch?
You know, there are not many players like Rainier who are gifted with the ball and with the talent that he has. You know, it's very exciting and sometimes it's scary when you like the kind of thing he can do with the ball and how dangerous he can be. It's like you have to be very much into your game and be focused all the time, and you need to know that this is a quality side that you're playing, and which as a player we enjoy playing against teams like that and players like that. You have Jaho, you have you name them, Hugo Bumos or Lafondre, even Ogbeche when he comes in. Now luckily he's in our team, you know, so we will definitely have him in our side against Mumbai City, so which is an advantage for us. But yes, having said that, yeah, it was a very exciting two matches against them. The first one, they beat us, but the second game, I think we could have won. But then, you know, Mumbai City, they are a very good quality side. Even they had the chances in that game. And this season is going to be different, I believe. And it's going to be so much fun this time around. And yeah, I look forward to that fixture. Yeah, very exciting fixture ahead.
Right. And if I could just get both of you, before talking about your fixture against each other, about the first fixture. Now, what do you feel first? How do you look at that opening fixture of yours?
Again, Chennai, yes, they are a very good side. They have a lot of good Indian players as well as they have recruited foreign players, and their coach is new. And we haven't seen any visuals about how their playing style is going to be. As the season goes, of course, our mister is going to tell us that how to play against them and how it's going to be. But it's going to be the first match, so we wouldn't have much, you know, maybe in the preseason, if we are lucky enough to play against them in the preseason, or even if not, if you get some videos or some style or some ideas about how they play. If not, then we will focus on ourselves and we will want to start with a good result and, of course, with our brand of football.
Yeah. And Rainier facing FC Goa in the opening match, how do you rank them as opposition and what approach are you going to take for that game?
For me, personal experience, this first game is going to be a banger. Because like everyone know, FC Goa did well last season in the Super League. And as well as, you know, when they played the AFC, they did extremely well. And I ended up cheering them because the quality football they produced. They ended up, you know, in such a nice, good note. So coming to this season, you know, with the same coach, with almost the same players, they're looking forward to a good season. And it's going to be a very thriller game from their side and from my side as well. And yeah, we just cannot wait, you know, just to get back and try to play the first match, you know, as good as possible. You know, what we did last year, we want to try to train even more harder than last season, try to come back on the field and try to play much, much better game and try to get those 3 points, you know, in the first opening game. Yeah, so this is what we are looking forward to. It's very, very excited about it.
Now, guys, a question I want to pose to the both of you is that this is the second season that's going to be happening inside BioSecure Bubble. Both of you have had the chance to have that experience in the first season. So what are your individual learnings from that season, which you can then take and apply into the coming season, which will help both you and your team? Are there any such learnings? Rainier, why don't you go first?
Like for me, like this last year was my third season playing in the Indian Super League. So the first season, the first two seasons, like, you know, we were all, like, everything was open. Like, you know, there was no bubble, there was no restrictions. So, but during that time, you know, like during the day-to-day life, it gets very difficult, like, you know, to go and meet all the players because they have been doing some other things. And like, you know, they are going out, they are trying to take care of themselves in their own possible way. We are doing the same thing, trying to be safe, trying to take care of ourselves. But last season in the bubble, you know, everyone were together. So it was, there was no one like, you know, trying to go away or like, you know, going out of the hotel, trying to get their, like some food, their diet. Everything was surrounded or around in the hotel. So it was very easy, firstly, to communicate. And most of the times, at least our team, we used to like, you know, get together. We used to, we had a lounge. So we used to get together over there. We used to bond over there because in football, for me, off the pitch, you know, the bonding is very much important because once you go on the pitch, you already know that, you know, what he's looking for, what, like, how you say, like, there are many good things that, you know, what you learn off the pitch. So that's what, like, you know, well, last season, that is what made me happy and what made the club happy, because the bond what we had, that's the reason, you know, we had such a great season and that's how we achieved everything, because we were like a family. And now since it's going to be the second season, yes, you know, everyone are going to miss our loved ones. You know, it cannot be possible that, you know, we can go home, meet all our parents and everyone, all these things. It's going to be very difficult. But now since it's been quite some time, everyone were together, but now it's time to work and you have to make all these sacrifices. And now again, we're going to get back into the bubble and it's a bit like, you know, not that great because we're going to be away from the family, but that's how life is. We got to get back. We got to be a family now, a different kind of family as a team. We got to bond and we just got to do well in the entire season.
Yeah. Sana, do you concur? How do you see Bubble Life 2.0?
I agree to Rainer with a lot of points there that he mentioned. There's one thing that is very positive about the bubble is that the team is always together. And, you know, even on off days, we're together playing, you know, whether it's a gully cricket or lawn tennis, whatever. I mean, table tennis or whatever you have in the hotel. You don't have any other access, right? So you get to spend a lot of time with your friends and colleagues. And sometimes we talk about the game or we talk about our families. But that makes us come closer to one another, and which really helps. And which the chemistry goes on the pitch as well. You know, when we celebrate, when we score a goal, we celebrate. It's more like a family. Which doesn't happen in without the bubble. So bubble in some way it's a blessing in disguise, I would say, because after games, you sometimes when you have home and away matches, you have to travel, and that has completely taken out. So you have more time to rest, recover, and think about the game the next day itself. So it's a lot of positives, I would say, even with the bubble. But one thing we definitely miss is the fans. You know how football is beautiful with the fans. How much we miss them. The chance when you're tired. When it's 80 plus minutes, that's when the fans come in. You know, you need that extra bit of power, you know. That's when we really miss the fans. But it is what it is. We can't complain. And yeah, but definitely I hope that we get to play in front of beautiful crowds. And I look forward to that. And I hope that comes soon.
Now that you did mention the fans, Sana, if you were to give one message to the Hyderabad FC faithful, what would it be ahead of the coming season?
I think the last season, the experience that I've had with the Nizams, with the Hyderabad FC fans, and we interact a lot with the fans through sometimes videos or sometimes even on Instagram and social media that we have. I mean, it's amazing, man. I mean, for a new club like Hyderabad FC to already have a fan base, and they are so supportive. They send you messages, they support you, they send their loves, and we hear them. We sometimes reply. We can't reply everyone, but yes, the fan base that we have, we interact with them. I mean, it's great. And I hope that they continue supporting us in the way that they've done. And it's going to be an exciting season. And it's going to be very challenging as well. And we need their support and even more love that they've shown. And we are counting on them, yeah.
And Rainier, what about that support from the West Coast Brigade that you've continuously gotten over the last few seasons? Your words for them ahead of the season?
It like how Sana said earlier that, you know, we are going to miss the fans in the stadium, and we as footballers, you know, we want these fans, you know, to be there. Like how you said, during the dying minutes, during when you're winning, they're losing, they're always there as a constant support. But unfortunately, they are not going to be there this season as well compared to the last season. But in the last season and what I have witnessed is that, you know, like all the years, they are always there. It's just they were not there physically. They were there constant. They were sending messages, DMs, everything what a fan does. They were just doing it and they were just showing all their love and support. And, you know, in some matches, like during the semis, I feel, or during the, like, you know, the important matches, the coach used to get the videos the management used to arrange some videos, you know, of the fans, you know, like, you know, trying to support us, trying to show the love and passion and everything. So when you see these moments, you feel that, you know, they are literally there in the stadium. And it is unfortunate that they won't be this season, but I just want the same love and support what they showed all these years. They are doing a great, great job. They're supporting us unconditional, and just too much respect to them, because they're always there by our side. They're always there in our good times, bad times, and they're always there around. So I just want to say that we are going to get back, you know, sooner, and we just want the same love and support from all of our fans.
That's brilliant, Rain. Yeah. And lastly, final question to the both of you. Now, if there was one thing that you want to do differently going into this coming season, what would it be? Rainier, I know it's hard to pick one because you were champions last season, so it wouldn't really make sense to do things differently. But if there was one thing that you could think of, what would that be?
Yeah, there are actually many things differently that I would do. But now that we are going to come looking for a season is, like, you know, try to get, like, you know, deal better with the pressure when it's during the game, or where it's, you know, another game coming up, or during the, like, you know, when if we are having a bad day during the game. So just deal with the pressure. I would want to do it differently.
I think I need to say something to Rainer, man. New dance move, please. Because he dances really well. That's something you can do differently now.
Not yet, Sarah, not yet.
Awesome, guys.
For me, I think as a player, the challenge is that to keep improving from the last season that you have had. And that is the best challenge you can have as an individual, you know, to do better than what you have done the last season. And that is something that I really pay attention on, whether it's my diet, whether it's my time at the gym, or even in the training pitches. Every time you need to give your best, you need to want to improve. That's the only way, I think, to grow as a player. Because if you can do that, and you can help the team immensely, you know, by contributing in the team's victory and everything. So I think that's the only way. And that is something that I would continue, and not differently, but in the same manner. But yes, differently to improve than what I've done in the past. That's the way I think I'm going to follow.
Absolutely. On that note, guys, thank you so much for joining us here today, discussing the fixtures and a lot more about the coming season. And best of luck to the both of you individually and to your respective teams for the upcoming season.
Thank you
very much. Thank you very much. Nice talking to you, brother.
See you guys. See you, Sana.
See you, Reina. I'll text you on WhatsApp, Reina. Bye.